Hello, YouTube people. Let's talk about this beautiful Festina dress watch. So about the Festina, I have to say that I don't really like how Festina divers and Festina chronographs look like. They are very busy, very colorful, playful, a little bit too much for me, not my kind of thing. But on the opposite of that, Festina makes very beautiful dress watches. I would even go this far and say that Festina makes the best looking dress watches for under 100 euros. Festina dress watches are the complete opposite of Festina divers and chronographs. As mad and crazy these divers and chronographs are, as simple and clean and elegant Festina dress watches are, I honestly prefer simplicity, cleanliness, elegance, and that's the reason why I bought this watch, because in my opinion, this is the best looking dress watch for under 100 euros. So what was my first impressions? First impressions was like, this watch looks a little bit too big for me. My hand for this watch looks a little bit too small as for a dress watch. But I've been wearing this watch for several days and my eyes got used to the size, and I think it's alright. After my eyes got used to that, I think it's alright. But I'm not entirely sure, you know, but because it's a dress watch, the dress watches are supposed to be a little bit on the smaller side of things to look elegant. So I'll ask your opinion. What do you think? How this watch looks on my hand in these shots? Leave me a comment. Is it okay or is it too big? What's your opinion? Because I honestly don't really understand that well about dress watches. So you tell me. You know, and I also want to mention one thing. I watch a lot of YouTube channels, and there is one channel which I really like a lot. They do a lot of very, very beautiful macro shots and very good voiceover. That channel is called Watchfinder and Co. And they review watches that cost a lot, like price tags are this long and they have a lot of zeros in the prices. And when I saw this Festina for 60 euros, I was amazed, because this watch looks exactly like that, like one of those watches from Watchfinder and Co. YouTube channel. Of course, it's like from certain distance. When you look up close in a macro level, yeah, you're gonna see the difference. But from this kind of difference, it looks exactly the same. This Festina looks a lot more expensive than it is. Not double, not triple the price. This Festina looks like it should cost like with a lot more zeros in the price. That's how good it looks like. And in person, with a naked eye, it looks really beautiful. Absolutely wonderful. And I will mention all the points why it looks that beautiful. So all watches have positive, negative points, and I have some made a list of these points. So let's talk about each point and let me tell you more about this watch. And quickly about the specs of the watch. It has 50 meters water resistance, which as for a dress watch is wonderful. Most dress watches have 30 meters water resistance, which means they are just splash proof. And this one with 50 meters water resistance means that you can actually submerge it into the water. You can actually do light swimming with this watch, which is wonderful. Another measurement, this watch is only 7 millimeters in thickness. And the diameter of this watch is 39.5 millimeters by my measurements. Lug to lug distance is 46 millimeters, which I would say is medium size. And lug width is odd 19 millimeters. Well, the first point I written down is that this watch has no stupid print on the face. The face of this watch is clean. There is no stupid print like quartz, water resistance, that or other things. I really don't like those prints, and it's very difficult to find a clean watch, clean face for this kind of money. And Festina actually understood how a dress watch should look like. and they made a wonderful job with it. Seriously, no stupid text, it's just Festina logo and the brand name, that's all. Well done. And speaking about the print, these numbers, I don't know if they are printed in some kind of interesting way or applied, but this black text of these numbers, it has some thickness. It's like 1 millimeter, maybe half of the millimeter in thickness. And you can clearly see with a naked eye that these numbers are not just simple print. They have thickness, they look really good, they look premium. And when you play with the light, looking close up to this watch, you can see the edges of these numbers playing around with the light. You can see that these numbers, they look very 3D, they look applied. And that's a very, very big plus point I would give, because that looks very premium. That looks like an expensive watch, even up close like this. And since I mentioned that it looks good up close, I wanna say a next positive point. These little dots, these little shiny hour markers, they look absolutely wonderful. It's very hard to make a good picture or video showing these dots, how they play out in the light. But when you wear this watch and you check the time, sometimes these dots sprinkle, sparkle so nicely. And it's a dress watch, so it kind of fits the theme. But what I like, that these little dots are just enough of sparkliness to the watch. It keeps it elegant, keeps it sophisticated, yet it's not overdone. It's not too much. It's not like the whole bezel, it's sprinkly, sparkly like a toy of a Christmas tree. No, just a little tiny dots, and they sparkle just sometimes, just in the right light, and that's such a nice, elegant look. I love it. Wonderful. So let's move on to the next positive point. And I would put these hands to the positive point, because they look wonderful. To the naked eye, there is no imperfections. The shape of those hands, it's so nice. There is no fake stupid loom, and they have a very nice edge in the middle, which plays with the light very nicely. These hands are so elegant, so nice. But there is one thing about these hands that I will mention in the negative points, but about that a little bit later on. And another point, which I would say is positive, that this watch doesn't have seconds hand. You would ask, why? Why is the positive point? Well, first of all, it's a quartz watch. So a lot of people don't like how a seconds hand of a quartz watch looks like, how it jumps, especially with these cheap watches. And it would be annoying if this seconds hand would miss the markers and such. And quite honestly, it looks just so much better, so much cleaner without any additional seconds hand. I don't miss seconds hand on this watch at all. It's a very good decision to make this watch without seconds hand. Well, another interesting point about this watch, I don't know, but I'm gonna put this into positive points because it's interesting. So when you look at this minute hand with your naked eye, you don't notice that. But when you look at these macro shots, as I'm showing you right now, you can see that this minute hand clicks every two seconds. And those shots you are seeing are not speeded up, are not slowed down. They are just real time. And pay attention how minute hand moves. It's really interesting. I never saw a movement like this that ticks every 2 seconds. It looks so cool. Really, a quirky feature. I put it into plus points. And another plus point. Well, there are many cheap quartz watches, but not all of them are really good quartz watches. And by saying that, I mean that these movements usually are, well, pretty bad. By saying bad, I mean they tick loudly. And I hate that. I hate quartz watches that have ticking noise. I just cannot wear one. It's just so annoying to me. And this watch, even if I put it next to my ear and listen very, very carefully, it doesn't make any noise whatsoever. And that's a very big plus point for me to this watch. This quartz watch doesn't have ticking noise. Great. Another very obvious positive point of this watch. It has a very bright dial and very contrasting numbers. And these hands are shiny and very easy to see in all kinds of lighting situations. So this watch is very easy to read. Even if you have a bad eyesight from close up, you're still gonna see this watch fairly well without much trouble. Except this date window. Date window for some people might be too small, but white date window with black numbers, it's pretty good. So readability of this watch is very good. That's a good plus point. Another plus point that I'm gonna give for this watch is pretty big one, pretty big plus point, because I'm going to compare the comfort of this watch to Casio F91W. And in my opinion, Casio F91W is the perfect form factor. It feels absolutely wonderful on the hand because it doesn't feel at all. You don't feel the watch on your hand with F91W. And I will go this far and say that this Festina dress watch feels the same as F91W. And it's very slim, very light. And after you bend this leather strap to have this kind of shape to hug your wrist, it sits on the hand perfectly fine. I've been wearing this watch all day long. It doesn't get hot, it doesn't get uncomfortable, it doesn't wobble around. It's wonderful. If you are office worker, if you work at office and you want to have a daily watch that you can grab and go and forget that you have something on the hand that it doesn't get in the way throughout your day, this watch is wonderful. You can easily wear it every day and it gets under tightest cuff, no problem whatsoever. Plus points, plus points. And I would also give another plus point for this watch. It's about the finishing, the overall finishing of this watch. To the naked eye, I see absolutely no imperfections on this watch. Everything is done in such a nice way. These numbers, these little dots, these hands, date window, the case, everything. To the naked eye, everything looks absolutely perfect. No imperfections, no dust under the glass, nothing. Really great finishing. And another positive point, I would put this date window to positive points because it's very difficult to design in a date window on a dress watch, especially on a simple, clean design, without destroying the look of the watch. There are so many dress watches with date windows that completely destroy the design. Even Festina itself has several dress watches with date windows that completely destroy the design of the watch. But with this one, it creates such a nice symmetry with Festina logo. And it looks like that without this date window, this watch would look too empty, too plain. And this date window just adds to overall look. It creates the perfect balance, the symmetry with Festina logo. Wonderful, very, very well done. And having a date window is always a plus, especially if it's done right, like here. Another small positive point, I would say not only the face of this watch looks absolutely wonderful, also the back case. Just take a look at the back case of this watch. Wow, such a nice Festina logo. Everything is done so nicely. It shines so good. So good, really. Wonderful. Looks absolutely beautiful. Okay, so those are positive points. But as all things, this watch also has negative points. And these negative points, I thought they aren't even worth mentioning because they are very simple. First negative point is the lug width. The lug width is 19 millimeters. So it's odd size. It's hard to find. But the thing is, it's a dress watch. It's not some kind of a strap monster. So it's not a problem if this watch has 19 millimeter lug width. Because when you're gonna wear out this leather strap, you're gonna find another one, replace it, and gonna be good for next year or several years. So you aren't gonna change it every day. I don't know, it's not a negative point, I would say. I just wanted to mention this watch has 19 millimeter lugs. Another point. I don't know, is it negative? As for dress watch, not so much, I would say. At this price level, also, nah. This watch doesn't have sapphire crystal, it's mineral crystal. But as for a dress watch, I wouldn't say it's a big negative point, because you ain't gonna fix your car or your bicycle wearing this watch. Well, if you're gonna wear this watch every day into the office, yeah, maybe you're gonna scratch it a little bit, but you ain't gonna do any manual work with this watch anyway, so sapphire crystal is not a requirement for a dress watch, I would say. Mineral is just fine. I just wanted to mention that. So, as I was talking in the plus points about these hands, these beautiful hands, I thought I was gonna mention something in negative points as well. And even though those hands look wonderful, really great, well done hands, if you look up close to this watch from the side, you're gonna notice that these hands are very, very slim. And I don't know, is it worth putting that into negative points? But that kind of cheapens the look a little bit. Well, usually when you look at the watch, you don't even notice the thickness of the hands, and it's all good, all fine. But when you look up close, these are very slim, very thin hands, and I wish there was some kind of thickness that would look much more luxurious, much more premium. So the conclusions of this watch, as you have noticed, I am really struggling to point out any negative points. And even those negative points that I have mentioned, they are just, you know, me trying too hard. They aren't really negative points, come on. Mineral crystal on a dress watch is not a negative point. It's a dress watch, it's not a tool watch. Another negative point that I mentioned, 19mm lugs. Also, it's not a strap monster, you aren't gonna change straps every day. You're gonna change the strap only when it wears out, so it's not a problem at all, seriously. And those hands being too slim, too thin, you know, these hands look absolutely wonderful. Really nice shape, really nicely done. This edge throughout the middle of these hands, wonderful. And putting a negative point on the fact that these hands up close from this distance look a little bit too slim, too thin, too cheap. It's, come on man, really, on a 60 euro watch, it still looks absolutely incredible. It's just me trying too hard to find some kind of negative points. It's not really a negative point, it's just something to talk about. So overall, I see only positive points in this watch. Absolutely wonderful. Such a wonderful creation Festina done. Wow, everything. These numbers, these little dots, the symmetry between Festina logo and the date window, even the case back, and especially the feel on the hand, how this watch feels. It feels like F91W. Really? Yeah, that good. It's that good. Wow, wonderful. And speaking about this leather strap, I'm gonna be honest with you, I don't really understand about leather straps. I can tell you a thing or two about metal bracelet or rubber strap, but I don't really know about leather straps. Well, at least for me, this one feels okay. So if I compare this watch in a comfort to F91W, then I would say, yeah, it's a good strap. That I can tell about this strap. How it's gonna hold up, I have no idea. But it looks all right. It looks all right. Can't really complain. So, if you are looking for a watch for those special occasions, perfect. Perfect watch. If you're looking for a watch to wear every day in your office, also perfect watch. It even has a date window, which is very useful. So, what a wonderful watch. Seriously. I highly recommend this watch. For 60 euros, this kind of design, without stupid print on the face, quartz, water resistance, this and that. Come on. It's a wonderful watch. Wow. And it looks so much better in person than in these pictures or videos. It's so difficult to make it look as good in video, as good as it looks like in person. Trust me, this watch is absolutely wonderful. You ain't gonna be disappointed. Believe me, for 60 euros, this kind of beauty, this kind of elegance, sophistication, and so on and so on. Oh, yes, please. Yes, please. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Goodbye.